साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः वी आर इन विवेक चुडामणी वर्स नंबर 176 विल बी स्टार्टिंग And we are seeing here the Manomaya Kosh. I think that's the one. Manomaya Kosh, the mind sheath. And we are seeing how this mind sheath is the cause of all troubles. How it is keeping us away from ourselves. How we become enslaved by it. How it influences us. And how, for the individual being, not for the Atman, for the individual who is nothing but another aspect of the mind alone, how this mind alone is the instrument for an individual in order to liberate. Really speaking, we'll talk about the really speaking part afterwards. So, he is, the individuality is an idea in the mind, and this mind alone becomes an instrument for the individual to choose whether he is in bondage or is liberated. He can choose. The choice is there. Can the mind make you liberated? No, mind cannot make you liberated. Mind cannot make you liberated, because mind itself is a product of ignorance. Mind itself is born under certain circumstances. It's a phenomena, and phenomena cannot give you the reality. But while this whole drama is going on in the mind, the individual can be the witness of the whole game that is going on, and that disposition of being a witness to this drama of the mind, to the workings of the mind, to the seeking of the mind, to the bondage and liberation thoughts in the mind. All this is going on in the mind. He has to just be the witness, be the observer, an unenchanted observer, not responding, not identifying with anything that is going on in the mind. So this we saw till last week. Tasman mana karanamasya jantoho. Tasman mana karanamasya jantoho. Bandhasya mokshasya chava vidhane. Bandhasya mokshasya chava vidhane. बंधस्य हेतुर्मलिनं रजोगुणैः बंधस्य हेतुर्मलिनं रजोगुणैः मोक्षस्य शुद्धं विरजस्तमस्कम् मोक्षस्य शुद्धं विरजस्तमस्कम् Therefore, with what we have just now told, therefore the cause of bondage, तस्मात् मनः कारणम् अस्य जन्तोः the individuals, the beings. Therefore, the cause of bondage and liberation for the jiva is certainly the mind. Bandhasya mokshasya cha va vidhane. Indeed, wow, indeed. Mind alone brings about the bondage. Mind alone is an instrument which can bring you to the to the doors of liberation. It cannot make you liberated, but it can get you there. Bandhasya hetur malinam rajogunaihi. Bandhasya, bondage begins the moment rajoguna becomes active. So here it is told, when it is mixed with rajoguna, it becomes the cause of bondage. What is mixed with rajoguna? Mind is mixed with rajoguna. Mind is the sattva, rajas, tamas coming, the movement of these three. But then when they say, when mind mixes with rajoguna, see, mind is essentially what? Essentially, I said, listen to the question. What is mind essentially? No. Mind is essentially consciousness.
Consciousness identified with
that. No, don't go into all that. Mind is essentially consciousness. Wave is essentially water, isn't it? Where is the birth and the death of wave?
In the water.
Is it?
Appearance is
it's only an appearance. There is no birth of a wave, there is no death of a wave. Before the wave also water was there, during the wave also water was there, after the wave also water was there. So let's not go into that example more deeper, but understand, essence of the mind is consciousness. Then in this mind, when is consciousness called a mind? When is consciousness called a mind? The moment it starts pumping out thoughts or absence of thoughts, then it is called mind, right? What is mind? The two polarities, manifest mind and unmanifest mind, isn't it? So here, when they say that bandhasya hetur malinam rajogunaihi, when this mind is mixed with rajoguna, it becomes the cause of bondage. And when it is without the contamination of rajas and tamas, predominantly sattvic, it leads to liberation. Now tell me, when it is tamas, is tamas bondage? Is there any problem? When the mind is sleeping, when the mind is zero, are you having trouble?
Yeah,
are you in bondage? You don't even know it. But you don't know that you are in bondage, isn't it? And therefore, the statement that ignorance is bliss. So everyone, when he is sleeping, you are not worried or agitated or enslaved by anything. All your problems become zero the moment you go to sleep, isn't it? But the moment rajoguna, so deep sleep is the cause, and that is unmanifest, and from that manifest comes out. So tamas is the cause and rajas comes out of tamas. Tamas is the foundation of these. So out of that rajas comes out. Tamas means what? Another word for it? Non-apprehension, self-forgetfulness. And the multiplicity hasn't begun yet. But the moment multiplicity begins, thoughts start appearing in the mind, at that very moment, bondage begins. And what is this bondage due to? Identification. See? Identification with whatever is getting pumped out. Whatever is getting thrown out into the mind as thoughts, the moment you identify with thoughts, you are in bondage. So are we in bondage right now when we are talking? You are listening to words and I am speaking with words? Yes. Yes, we are in bondage. See? But what did we say? Mind itself is a cause for bondage. Mind itself can take you to the doors of liberation. So within this bondage, within this mind, we have to choose what activities will help us, what thoughts will help us to come to that point where we can drop the mind. The example given here is just like a high jumper. he takes the pole vault, he jumps high. Without the pole, he cannot reach that height. But he jumps high. He looks at the bar which he has to cross, puts the entire body across the bar, still holding on to the pole, which catapulted him all the way to the top. Maybe 3-4 times the height of his. And from there, then when he sees that he is safe, every part of his is on the other side, then he lets go of the pole vault exactly the same way. This mind is also like our pole vault. You can take it, you can soar high, and once, and as you soar high, thinking of sattvic thoughts, thinking of the reality, and as clarity comes, as conviction becomes undoubted, and at that time, the pole vault is let go. Now you will start thinking, oh, so I have to give up the mind. In our case, there he is making a conscious action of letting go of the pole. Here we don't do any conscious action of letting go of the mind. The mind merges into its source. But it can help you to soar to that subtle height, that sattvic height of contemplation. So again, when it is mixed with the rajoguna, it becomes the cause of bondage. Whenever, and what is rajoguna thoughts? All thoughts of object, emotions, or all thoughts. Thoughts can be of the world, thoughts can be of the emotions, and thoughts can be of the convictions, ideas, hallucinations. Whether it is sattvic, rajasic, tamasic, doesn't matter. But all this put together is equal to thoughts. Thoughts can be only about all these things. So when it is thinking about it, thinking about objects, emotions and thoughts of the world, of yourself, then it is in bondage. And when it is without the contamination of rajas and tamas and predominantly sattvic, it leads to liberation. And how do sattvic thoughts come about? How does sattvic disposition come about? How does sattvic disposition come about? Right now what we are doing, is it sattvic disposition?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
But we said thinking is rajasic.
Thinking about what?
What is the quality of thinking? Good. So this is sattvic. What would be the next stage of sattvic disposition of our mind?
Ignoring everything else.
No. If you are ignoring, means your attention is on the world. What will be the next stage?
Subside.
Subside.
Yes.
Sublimate. Okay. That will be. Do you need to continue to listen to satsang all the time or read the books all the time? No. Next stage would be, because whatever we are talking about here is about how the mind is the source of bondage or the source of instrument to which take binds you, or it can take you to towards liberation. So once you have recognized this, do we need to study anymore? So what would be the next stage from Shravanam? It will be Mananam. Next stage will be Nididhyasanam, contemplation. So when it should happen right now itself. These three stages must go on simultaneously. If you are available, you will bypass the reflection and straight away go to contemplation. Why reflection will be bypassed? Because if you do not have any doubt about what the scriptures are saying, what Shankaracharya is saying, or what the teacher is saying, if there is no doubt, then straight away contemplation will begin. Reflection only comes when there is doubt. And doubt is always about the world. Nobody has doubt about whether you are alive or dead, do you? So that which is alive, that which is life, that is the truth. Nobody has doubt about that. So doubt is always about the world. And these thoughts of the world are coming and corrupting our mind, and we are identifying with the mind, with those thoughts, and being less than who we essentially are. See? Therefore, moksasya shuddham virajas tamaskam. And when this mind is without the contamination of rajas and tamas, and predominantly sattvic, it leads to liberation. Then how do you bring it about to be sattvic? Think of the reality. Think of God. Think of the truth. Think of existence. Think of your essence. Think of the words, Uddhared Atmana Atmanam Natmanam Avasadhayet. Raise yourself by yourself, for yourself, using no other means. Self is the means, self is the goal. See? Oh, which self? Oh, are you not the self? Are you not conscious? So raise consciousness by consciousness for consciousness. Nothing else should come in between. Not even a thought. So mind can be thinking. Right now, when I made this statement, mind is thinking, therefore speech is coming, isn't it? But we are not talking about raising the mind. We are talking about the one who is observing that this dialogue happened, who is witnessing that. So when continuously, again and again, fall back, you can't catch it. Mind is trying to catch it. Mind cannot catch it. Yet you are. Yet you are. This reminds. Which has come many times in last 1 year, 2 years. I think, therefore I am. Or is it, I am, therefore thinking happens?
Latter, yes.
So, apply it on yourself right now. Right now, what are we doing? Thinking. Are you observing that in your presence, thinking is taking place? If you can have that disposition, right here and now, you are with yourself. But if you keep insisting that I need to understand, I need to work it out, I need to do my duties, I need to take care of my family, I have my responsibilities, I got a job to go, if I get realized, then how all this will happen? This is how mind sabotages. So right now we were thinking, and yet we are knowing that thinking is taking place. So keep coming back to this statement, that you are not trying to establish who you are through the thinking process. You have to, this is our disposition right now. And what is the teacher or the Upanishads or the scriptures or the great masters beckoning us? Hey man, you are, therefore thinking is happening. Take this position. We say, we are a seeker, we are a seeker. We are a seeker means we are not accepting that we are the truth. That we are the witness, that we are the Atman, we are not accepting. And therefore we have to keep seeking. Mind must remain a seeker throughout his life. Mind must remain a seeker. No doubt about that. But if you identify with the mind and say, I am a seeker for the rest of my life, then you will never, you never be. So this is a very simple statement by which you can correct your position at any given moment. Keep reminding yourself, I am, therefore thinking happens. Not the other way around. I think, therefore I am. So what is the impact of this statement? Start contemplating. You will fall back into yourself. In fact, what will happen is, if you are absolutely focused on I am, therefore thinking happens, and your attention goes to the I am, the conscious principle, very quickly, within few minutes, thinking will subside. Because your attention is not on thoughts, your attention is on Uddharet Atmanam. So consciousness has become aware of itself without thoughts. This is just words, conscious becoming aware of itself without thoughts. What does it mean? You don't understand. You cannot understand. Viveka vairagya gunatireka. Viveka vairagya gunatireka. Gunatirekat. Shuddhatvamasadhya mano vimuktyai. Shuddhatvamasadhya mano vimuktyai. Bhavatyato buddhimato mumuksho. Vatyato buddhimato mumuksho. Tabhyam drudhabhyam bhavitavyam agre. Bhyam drudhabhyam bhavitavyam agre. The mind becomes the means of liberation when it is further purified by intense discrimination and dispassion, etc. Therefore, an intelligent seeker must have strong and firm dispassion and discrimination. Meaning, now, this is for a seeker. So, every verse I am taking you to the ultimate position, and then again we are, when the next verse comes, again we start from the wherever the verse is. The mind becomes the means of liberation. So what did we say before? Mind is the means of bondage as well as liberation. When does mind become means of liberation? When it harbors within itself the capacity to discriminate and capacity to let go or give up or be dispassionate about everything that is changing. What is changing? The world. What is the world? Objects, emotions and thoughts. Isn't it? What is the world? Everything else other than the self is the world. We have seen that in the previous verses. So, we can talk about all this, but unless and until we don't put it into practice in life. So, when you are practicing discrimination, I am the self, I am not the not self. Everything that is changing, I am not. If you have really understood what that statement is, that all changing, I am not. What is not what is that which is changing all the time? The thoughts are changing, the convictions are changing, the ideas are changing, the emotions are changing, the breath is changing, the body is changing, the world is changing. All this I am not. then what is the impact of this statement? Have you made it your own? If you have made it your own, you will have no interest in this world then. You will have no interest in this world. Niras. You will not seek joys out of this world then. Because you have become convinced that this world is changing. It gives me temporary joys, but it can never give me that permanent peace and tranquility that I am seeking. That which is my nature, this world can never give me. Then what is your disposition? A nirastha, a viraktata, an indifferent attitude towards the world. The more your mind becomes indifferent towards the world, dispassionate towards the world, disinterested in the world, energy is still there. All your energy is still there. You take that energy and become, you utilize it for even deeper discrimination. Deeper discrimination. So, because now the less distractions. See, the fact that you are here at this moment, at one level of your mind, you are not allowing the world to distract you from coming to the satsang. Isn't it? At this moment, there so many sounds are going on outside. Crickets are there, that dog was there, or someone suddenly the phone rings, or many thoughts are coming in your mind. But you choose not to be distracted by them and remain focused on the topic that is going on. Isn't it? That is what happens. So that is what you are practicing. But you have to go deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper into it. Don't leave it, do it only at the superficial level. And you can go deeper. So at some discrimination is going on. That is why you have committed to drop all your shows, movies, friends, all social commitments and come to satsang. So discrimination is there. That's why you are indifferent to what is going on in the world at the moment. But this attitude, which is a healthy attitude, it must go deeper. It must go deeper. Not only with regards to the world, not only once or twice or thrice a week. It has to happen 24/7. 365 days a year. So our attempt should be there, deep inside. We don't have to talk to anyone. Continuously keep assessing. Is my attention on the self? Keep discriminating. Am I still giving value to the world? How do you say I am giving value to the world? Am I getting disturbed by the world? Am I seeking the world? Am I wanting to make an impact in the world? Do I feel that I am a part of this world? Do I feel that I have got some axe to grind in this world, some purpose in this world? As long as these type of thoughts are there, you are still caught up in the world. It will not happen. Change may happen by grace in one go. For many masters it has happened. But recognize that this is how it is. And all we have to do is increase our attention, make our focus more on the thought of the self, and automatically we will be indifferent towards the world. The more we are indifferent towards the world, more will be our attention on the self. The more the attention on the self, even more indifferent to the world. So from the outer periphery, slowly, 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 we keep going in. This is what happens in Kundalini Abhyas. This is what happens in Kriya Yoga. This is what happens in, this is Gyan Marg which you are following. Same thing happens in the Vaikari Madhyama Pashyanti Para. Same thing happens in Japa Sadhana. Everything is, they are all parallel. Exactly the same thing is going on. From the periphery, slowly, slowly we come to the core. What is the core? The self. See? And when do you remember the self? In and through all activities. In and through all activities. Experiment with yourself. Not with the world. Not with the world. With yourself. Try to. Bring your attention again and again to the self. Therefore, intelligent seekers must have strong and firm dispassion and discrimination. It's two-sided. Mind should be totally focused on the self, and at the same time, the mind should be totally indifferent and dispassionate towards the world. Meaning, it should not have any desire for the world. But then how will I, if I'm hungry, should I not eat? That is not a desire. It is a natural phenomena. If it is a natural phenomena, then you will eat food. Desire enters in food. When you are hungry, becoming hungry is not a desire. But I eat only this and not that, then it becomes a desire. I eat only chapati and not rice, it becomes a desire. You understand what we are saying? And this is just one topic about food, but anything that is going on in life. You live a choiceless existence if you have given zero value to the world. And it may happen, it may not happen straight away. But recognize this is the way it functions. This is the way you have to go. So bring it about slowly, slowly. And you don't have to force yourself to run away or be indifferent to the world. All we have to do is discriminate strongly. Come back to the source again and again. And source, this self, this Atman, it is all-knowing. It is unconditional love. If you do it this way, by focusing on the self, then your indifference towards the world, it will not be a forced one. You will not tell people, I don't care about this world. I don't care who you are. I don't know. It will be more elegant. It will be very smooth. It will come across as compassion. It will come across as love. How it will come across, that is not your concern. Because you are as an individual, you are a product of your past. So, but the more mind purifies, the more elegant, harmonious, empathetic, unconditional its disposition is towards the world. Because as you are coming towards the self, one more thing is happening. And what is that? Slowly, 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 your vision about the world is also changing at the same time. Rather than seeing this world as something to abhor, something to run away from, you are going to see that this self alone is the whole world. But don't try that initially. Don't try that initially. It just comes I was with Swamiji and something like this was going on. I said, Swamiji, I get overwhelmed with the love that the world is having towards me. Or I am having towards the world. Everything is taken care of. I am nobody. And yet everything is there. You know, people's love, people's respect, people's reverence. I am also having that disposition, and even more so it comes back. I feel undeserving sometimes. I feel overwhelmed by it. He says, let it go on. You remain focused on the self. These things will happen. And the moment these things happen, we want to go and make a difference in the world. We forget the Atman and we go back into the world. Many people do this. When the Siddhis come, this is what happens. Some brainwave comes. I will open something and I'll start a soup kitchen, or I'll start giving free food. If it happens naturally, effortlessly, fantastic. But if it happens as a desire, beware, beware. You are shortchanging yourself. Now you are giving attention to the world. This is how the mind sabotages the whole thing. Because the mind's natural disposition, now it's coming in the next verse, mind's natural disposition is to go out there in the world. Isn't it? The moment you wake up, there are two things. Either you want to go back to sleep, or you as the day goes, you get more and more and more involved in the world. So here the next verse says, Mano nama mahavyagro, Mano nama mahavyagro, Visayaranyabhumishu, Charatyatra na gacchantu, Sadhavoye mumukshavaha. A terrible tiger named as the mind is always moving around in the forest of the worldly objects. Therefore, the sincere seeker of truth should not go there. What did you understand? Tell. What did you understand from that statement? That a terrible tiger named as the mind is always moving around in the forest of worldly objects. Therefore, a sincere seeker of truth should not go there. What do you mean by that?
Should not follow the mind.
Should not identify with the mind. So, on one hand, we are telling you, keep the attention on the self, discriminate the self and the not self. It does not mean when we say discriminate the self and the not self, keep thinking about it. Self is not an object to think. See? So the moment we say discrimination, this whole book is about discrimination. So many words are there, but it is still keeping you in mind, isn't it? So what we are saying is, what Shankaracharya is saying is, discriminate. And discrimination is only about self and not self. Once you are discriminated that you are the self, be the self. Without thinking about the self. Now in this verse, what is he saying? That even if thinking is going on, because mind's nature is to think, mind's just like eyes' nature is to see, ears is to hear, tongue is to taste, nose is to smell, skin is to feel, mind is to think. You can't stop it from thinking. It will keep thinking about something, or it will go to sleep, or it will become zero. But that is its natural disposition. If you are trying to force it to stop thinking, it is an unhealthy disposition. So what are we trying to do it? We are through this process, we are trying to reprogram it. But that reprogramming is also through thoughts. Isn't it? It's still world. So whether the mind goes after objects, emotions and thoughts, whether the mind gets identified with the body, whether mind gets identified with the breath, whether the mind gets identified with the emotions, whether mind gets identified with the convictions, it is still the and the conviction is I am. It's still the mind, it's still the world. See, don't get involved in it. Let the mind prowl around in the world. Don't identify with it. That, why am I going there? You are not going there. Mind is going there. Why did I have such a sensuous dream? You did not have the dream. The mind had the dream. Oh, I had the darshan of the Mahatma last night or when I was in meditation. You did not have. Mind had. Mind has n number of tricks to keep you in the loop. Loop within itself, to be identified. So what? So when here it says, Mano nama mahavyagro vishaya ranya bhumishu charat yatra na gacchantu sadho ye mumukshavaha. Therefore the sincere seeker of truth should not go there. Where the mind goes, one should not go. And mind can take you anywhere. A moment's notice. One moment of, in Hindi you say, asatarkta, meaning you are, for one microsecond, your alertness goes away somewhere. It's the razor's edge. You will cut yourself. You will find yourself enslaved by the mind. So this disposition, this witnessing disposition has to be maintained.
Manaprasute vishayana sheshan. Manaprasute vishaya nasheshan sthulatmana sukshmataya cha bhoktuhu. Sthulatmana sukshmataya cha bhoktuhu. Sharira varnashrama jati bhedan. Varnashrama jati bhedan. Gunakriya hetu phala ninityam. He
says, if the mind alone creates the gross and subtle objects, the gross body, classifications based on one's on the quality and stages in life, the various types, etc., and also differences on account of the attributes, activities, purpose, and effects, etc., for the enjoyer, jiva, all the time. So here, this is, the teacher is honing the point in our mind. First he talked about discrimination. First he told you that bondage is also by the mind, liberation also, mind is the means. Then he told you that this mind is like a tiger, is like a man-eater, who's moving around in the world of sense objects. Gross, subtle and causal. All the three areas. And he's prowling. What is he eating? Because this mind, how does he eat?
Through the senses.
He's continuously going out of the sense, getting attached. Eats this form. Meaning, envelops this form. And brings it back, hears this sound, brings it back into its database, and keeps filling. And its disk is infinite, there is no end to it. Keeps collecting, keeps collecting, keeps collecting. So if it is doing that, it is also doing for someone, isn't it? When it is collecting, it's collecting for whom?
Keep itself alive.
No.
It is collecting for someone. For whom is it collecting? For the individual. Because individual has given value to the mind that I am the mind. And therefore it's collecting information, collecting memories, collecting data, seeing, hearing, touching, feeling, tasting, thinking, which, all different things. Every moment it's going on. But if this jiva, if this individual has come to understand through discrimination, again using the mind, that I am the self and he remains a witness, mind goes, collects, wants to bring back and offer it at the altar of the individual, like a dog, you know, you throw the thing out, throw the ball, he runs after the ball, catches the ball, again comes and mind is also doing that. Close your eyes and see it right now. It's wanting to be appreciated. It's wanting to, you know, shabash Tony, you know, Rocky. And you give him a small bite or you take the ball from him and you throw again. Where has the world come out of? It's not a trick question. Where has the world come out from? Mind. Just like in the dream, mind itself became the whole world. Mind itself is throwing the ball. And this, and I have got identified with one body which the mind projected, and I am running after those balls. Or the mind is going and bringing it for this fellow, for this individual. Now, if this individual has taken the position of the witness, mind goes out, catches the ball, comes back, but there's no one to, no one is giving value to it. Nobody is accepting it. Nobody is accepting it. He becomes angry. The mind will become angry. It will bring even more powerful thing, more sensual thing, more something that can, that is of more value to this individual. It will dig it out from the memories. It will dig it out from somewhere. As the, if it finds that it's not getting importance, it will use all the tricks. But you, because your discrimination is strong, you stay, don't get affected. Eventually, just like that dog, gets tired of going around and now master is not giving attention. Then what will the dog do? Sit down. Leave the ball or hold the ball but sit down. Exactly the same thing the mind will do. It will, its activity of going out and coming back, going out and coming back, going out and collecting data, it will cease. This is possible only when you are the witness. And this is also possible and happening. If you want to learn and observe that this game is taking place, when you go to sleep. When your attention is on the sleep, mind goes, arre ye karna hai, arre wo karna hai, dheere dheere. But no, the person to whom it is bringing all these thoughts and ideas, he is focused on the sleep. The individual is focused on the sleep. He is not available to the data. And sometimes you must have said, I must remember this, tomorrow morning I'll remember. And next day you don't remember because you didn't give value to it. Your attention was more on sleep rather than what? Same thing will happen in meditation also. When your mind becomes calm and quiet, when you are contemplative, as the mind becomes quiet, creative ideas come out. You'll get lotto numbers also. Wherever your mind is stuck, as in your whole life or previous life, all those things, they will start, creative solutions will come in the mind. And you give value to those creative solutions. you have lost the plot. You have lost the plot.
So, here, when they say in this particular verse, it is the mind alone which creates the gross and subtle objects. So, this we have, in last few classes, we have talked about this topic. The mind itself has become the world. The mind itself has become all the bodies in the dream. The mind itself has become the saint, the gods, the Brahma, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, the characteristics, the anger, greed, jealousy, envy, ego, birth, death, arrogance, pride, everything that mind alone has become, isn't it? But when do you realize this? Only after you wake up. So what do we do to wake up in the waking? So that was a dream. You woke up from the dream and you realize that it was only a imagination of the mind. So if that was imagination of the mind, and when you were in the dream dreaming, was it an imagination? No, it felt real, isn't it? When you are dreaming, it feels real. When you wake up, then you say it is a dream. Exactly the same way, right now it seems real. Actually, it is a dream. Then how do we wake up from this? Remain a witness. Remain a witness. Waking state is a sattvic state. But within this sattvic state, when we discriminate, when we become dispassionate, when we remain, practice uddharet atmanatmanam, when our attention is again and again, the mind's attention is on the self, and we have focused on it to such an extent that now it's very easy for us to see that, hey, yes, it is the play of the mind. I don't even need to put attention because I am as I am. The mind can keep thinking that about the self, that nothing wrong. And therefore, recognize that all this is a game of the mind. The mind itself creates the individual and the world. Self does not become individual. Self has never fallen down from its pristine position of being the self. Self has never fallen down. Space has never become air, fire, water and earth. It allows their expression without getting disturbed by their presence. The water allows the expression of the waves and the tsunamis, but by itself it never gets disturbed. From the water's point of view, there is no wave, there is no tsunami, there is no ocean, there is nothing. It alone is. From the self point of view, it has never. Understand? This is your position. Then where is this jiva? The mind, just like a man identified with woman, becomes husband and man does not become husband and wife. Man becomes husband. Woman becomes wife. Right? Where is this husband? Is the man really there or husband really there? At that example level, okay? Man is the reality. Husband is an imagination. Exactly the same way. Now, where is the samsara going on? Is the samsara going on at the level of man, or is the samsara going on at the level of husband, which is imaginary? Exactly the same way. The self alone is, truth alone is, self alone is, and this mind becomes the aham vritti and idam vritti. I thought and that thought.
Understand? And this phenomena is going on. You cannot do anything about it. This is how we were born with. We are trying to find a way out of this quagmire. Out of this daldal. Daldal ko kya bolte hain? Sinking sand. Muck. It's pulling you in. And you want to get out of it. Koi baat. See? So this mind itself becomes the aham vritti and idam vritti. Aham vritti is also I, which is a thought. Self is also I, without a thought. And because we have been trained, programmed to think about ourselves as I, we forget that we are the eternal one. And we take the position of the thought I. If I have to talk about you, who are you? I'm Swami Paramananda. Immediately I have defined. Immediately I have defined. Otherwise, say stay silent. Have the power to stay silent and not be affected by what people say or the world says. So all these things which the mind is collecting out from there in the world is for whom? Is for this I thought, is for this ego, is for this individual, is for this ghost, is for this ghost. Who seems to be there but actually is not there. For him, the mind is collecting everything. Watch this game in yourself. And don't come down to that level. Remain a witness. It is going on right now. It's not that it's happening on special moments. It's happening all the time. And witnessing is also happening all the time. Question is, which one do you want to accept yourself to be? Do you want to be the thinking person? You know, in Panchadashi this thought comes. What was it? Gaunatma, Mithyatma and Mukhyatma. So do you want to be the Gaunatma? That I which is identified with things and beings and defining itself, accepting itself to be father, mother, daughter, sister, employer, employed, businessman, this, that, etc. Indian, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, rich, poor, joy, sorrowful, different identities. That is Gaunatma. Then Mithyatma, identified with the body. That it is accepting itself. Okay, I have understood, I am not the Gaunatma, they are imaginary. They are only a figment of imagination. So is identification with the body. If you think you are the body, I am a thinking person, I am a feeling person, I am a psychic person, I am a siddha person, I am a seeker, I am a liberated one, I am a father, not father, or I am gross body, subtle body, causal body, all this is also imagination only. This also is imagination. And Mukhyatma. So this is called Mithyatma. Mithya is what?
False.
That which seems, no, false, no. That which seems to be there but actually is not there. That is Mithya. That is Mithya.
Then the world is also seems to be there but not
there. Not there, exactly. Anything that is coming and going is Mithya. But we have to live it. Not just give lip service to it. So if everything that is changing, we are talking about the world, and that world also includes our body, breath, mind, intellect, thoughts, ideas, etc. Everything is mithya because they are coming and going. So hold on to that unchanging principle. That is why we are discriminating between the Atma and the Anatma. Anatma is mithya. Nitya is only one, the unchanging principle. Who is, in whose presence all this change is taking place? Be that. Right? So if you be that, then according to this verse, mind is bringing all the information for the I. But this I has recognized that it is the witness I. Now there is no one to accept it when he brings it. Like that dog. He comes, nobody to accept. So remember, a thought is created. Last week we talked about it. The triad is there. Knower, known, knowing. The mind goes. Mind is the knowing principle. It goes. It envelops the known and brings it to the knower. Then the thought that I know sofa comes about. So the mind has gone out, enveloped the sofa, brought, but the knower is missing. Because he's the witness. Then he will go and find something more stronger. Something, it has a fantastic database from memories. It will go into the conscious, then subconscious, and bring out something that will entice this fellow to come and own it. This is the game that is going on. So now understand, jiva is an idea in the mind. So don't, this has never settled with me. Papoham, papakarmaham, you know, I am a papi, I am a sinner, and please forgive my sins. You cannot be a sinner. Self can never be a sinner. Mind is a sinner. Thinking itself is a sin. Because it takes, what is sin? That which takes you away from the self is sin. What takes you away from the self? Thinking. Thinking creates a distance between you and yourself. See? So now your thing to remember from this verse or to be to the clarity is the jivatma is a product of the mind. You are not the jivatma. If you consider yourself to be the jivatma, jivatma is equal to mithyatma. And who are you essentially? Mukhyatma, the atma. Do you know the I thought appeared in the mind? Yes, I said it, I thought it, which means you are other than that. Keep taking that position again and again. And don't lose the plot.
Asangachid rupa mamum vimohya. Asangachid rupa mamum vimohya. Dehendriya prana gunair nibadhya. Dehendriya prana gunair nibadhya. Aham mameti brahmayatya jasram. Aham mameti brahmayatya jasram. Manasvakrutyeshu phalo pabhuktishu. Manasvakrutyeshu phalo pabhuktishu.
It is the mind which deludes as if the conscious self and ties it down through the attachment to the body, senses, activities, etc. and creates a sense of I and mine and makes the jiva wander in the enjoyments of different kinds through his karma. Self or Atma, is it karta or akarta?
Akarta.
Akarta. Self is akarta. Because what is the definition of self? Nitya, Shuddha, Buddha, Mukta, Swarupa, omniscient, all pervasive, one without a second, aham eka, ekam eva dvitiya. It is one without a second. So where, how can it work? Activity begins when there is otherness, when there is a sense of otherness. Then activity begins, then time begins. First time begins, then activity comes. See? So akarta, self is akarta. But here, makes the jiva wander in the enjoyment of different kinds. If you have considered yourself to be the thinking person and are proud about all the knowledge that you have, are convinced that you are an intellectual great, बहुत लंबा जाल छोड़ा है मन ने. The jivatma is totally caught in the clutches of the mind. Meaning? Yeah. And it is this mind which makes this jivatma, this individual I, to go, to seek, to desire, to aspire, to be ambitious, to be depressed, to be joyful, to be sorrowful, to tell him, hey, you know, all this you have tried, it's not good enough. Now become a seeker, become a yogi. You have to be liberated. This is also mind only. This is also mind. Oh, this journey is, you know, very long. There are 14 spheres of experience. 7 lower planes of experience and 7 higher. Higher are bhur, bhuvasuvah, mahajana, tapaha, satyam. And the lower ones, tala, tala, vitala, sutala, tala, tala, and goes down. And he starts believing it. It's like you're telling the wave, you know, you have to go through step by step, then you'll come to know your water. But you, who are standing outside, you know, wave is already water. This whole seeking business is just delaying the process. Isn't it? When you look at something else, it's easy to make this comment. Same thing is happening to you also. Kundalini jagrit ho gayi. Kya ho gayi? It's also an imagination. Because you accepted yourself to be a jiva, an individual, identified with this mind and body, and you start imagining that there certain steps have to take place. They will happen anyway. But don't get caught up in the steps. Be. Then it happens or it doesn't happen. Doesn't matter. We don't have to worry about it. So, who is creating this delusion? Who is creating this movie?
Mind.
Just like when we go into a movie theater, we go there, look at that movie, the screen is so huge, 70mm, nowadays though even bigger, IMAX, nowadays 3D. It's so real. It feels as if you are a part of the movie. If you wear those goggles and you wear the headphones. And you go through a roller coaster of experiences and emotions as to what is going on in the movie. You get caught up in it, isn't it? Exactly the same way. This jivatma is caught up in a mega theater called the mind. Called the mind. Movie ends. You come out. But our movie doesn't end. Day in, day out. It's continuing. But all this sequence of today, tomorrow, day after tomorrow, day to day after tomorrow, it's a part of the dream. It's only a projection in the dream. You are the witness. And where can you catch this witness? Right here and now. Be it. Not take this information and chew over it. No, nothing will happen. Or it may happen. We are not here to discuss that. Our attention has to come to the self. Be the self. The conscious self and ties it down through attachment to the body. How does the mind tie the jivatma down? By presenting all this data. By presenting all this data. And this jivatma says, starts thinking over a period of time that it cannot live without it. It cannot live without the body. It cannot live without the mind. It cannot live without the notions and convictions. It cannot live without its bed. It cannot live without its house, car, success, failure, many, many. It keeps identifying and identifying and identifying. And it becomes so burdened with everything that it has got identified with. And if you take it on a daily basis, it becomes so burdened that it needs to refresh itself. So it needs to go to sleep to get more energy so that it can burden itself even more. Who? Jivatma. This game is going on. This is the illusion. This is the phenomena that is going on. Therefore, there is nothing called soul. Jivatma is the soul. There is nothing called soul. What would be the soul of a wave? And is the water individual water? So after the wave dies, the soul of the wave goes, oh, where do I go and merge? Where is Vaikuntha? Will it come out of the wave and start searching for merging somewhere? No, it's a stupid idea. But it is told to the ignorant people who cannot chew, digest, consolidate what is being told right now. For majority of the people to accept that they are not the mind itself is a big, big barrier. Isn't it? If you are able to take it, you are very few chosen ones who are able to accept it. If you have accepted, that only you can know. So, through attachment to the body, sense activities and creates a sense of I and mine. That is also a game of mind only. It is in the mind only. The idea of I is also in the mind. The expansion of that I is mine. See? And makes the jiva wander in the enjoyments of different kinds through his karma. And once this mind comes, once this attachment comes, a desire is born. So this illusory entity called Jivatma, interacting, identifying with the illusory world of the body, breath, mind, intellect, space, air, fire, water, earth, etc. Then on account of identification and attachment with this world and this body, breath, mind, intellect, it starts having a desire for that which it has got attached to, and his life begins. And that beginning of the life, and what does he live life for? Two things. procure more and more and protect whatever he has. Therefore, in 12th chapter Bhagavad Gita, 12th, I think so, or 2nd chapter also, he says, Ananya Chintayanto Maam, Ananyas Chintayanto Maam, Ye Jana Paryupasate, Tesham Yutyabhi Yuktanam, Yoga Kshemam Vahamyaham. So this is what we are doing. Recognize this about yourself. You want to collect more and more, not only wealth and houses and money and everything, but thoughts, memories, information. Hey, keep collecting, keep collecting, keep collecting. And then what's the second part? Where does your energy go? To protect what you have collected. And what is Bhagavan saying there? Ananyas chintayanto maam. Ye jana paryupasate. Those people who, to the exclusion of everything in this world, put their attention on me, the Lord says in Bhagavad Gita. How? Tesham yukta, whichever way you can, whether through Aghor Marg, Kundalini Marg, Kriya Marg, Bhakti Marg, Yoga Marg, or Gyan Marg, which way does not matter. Whichever way you can. He says, Yoga Kshemam Vahamyam. I will give you what is required for you, and I will protect what you already have. So, your major, why you are doing all activity? To get more and protect. He has taken that out of your... So now you don't need any activity. Then what to do? Remember him. Contemplate on him. Meditate on him. And while doing everything in the world, wherever life is taking you, keep offering every thought, every emotion, every conviction, every wrong thought also, not only good thoughts, every wrong thought, every sensuous thought, every activity, keep offering to him till a point comes where he becomes more important than the offering. See? So the same thing what is told here is being told here also. So karma happens only when our attention is extrovert. Then karma, activity begins. For activity, three things again are required. What are the three things? The doer of activity, the instrument with which the activity is done, and the object for which the activity. To be procured. See? This, if everything is offered to the Lord, the doer, now what is he doing? He is offering all activity to the Lord. So that will not lead to more activity. It will lead to silence then. In Siddha Purushas, realized masters, activity is going on. We see them walking, talking, eating, sleeping, answering questions. But there is no owner. There is no karta there. There is no doer there. They also see, hear, touch, feel, taste, think. But there is no thinker. There is no seer. There is no hearer. There is no toucher. There is no feeler. There is no smeller.
Adhyasa doshat purushasya sansrutihi. Sadoshat purushasya sansrutihi. Adhyasa bandhas tvaman त्वमुनैव कल्पितः अध्यासबन्धस्त्वमुनैव कल्पितः रजस्तमो दोषवतो विवेकिनो रजस्तमो दोषवतो विवेकिनो जन्मादिदुःखस्य निदानमेतत् जन्मादिदुःखस्य निदानमेतत्
हि सेज़् हियर् It is on account of this mistaken identity that the embodied self is subjected to relative existence, and this bondage of mistaken identity is also projected by the same mind. See, therefore, for an intelligent person under the spell of rajas and tamas, this mistaken identity is the cause of the miseries like birth, death, etc. So this pseudo I, this ghost I, this thought I is also a projection of the mind alone. Don't be it. Your real identity is to be the witness that the mind is pumping out I thought and other thought, other thoughts. And we have taken ourselves to be that pseudo I. We have ourselves taken ourselves to be that ghost I. Why we have done that? It has happened. It's not, that's not, we are not here to prove how it happened, when it happened, what is the point. No, ignorance is beginningless. It happened. Now, is your seeking for finding out when it happened, or is it to get out of this quagmire now? Get out of this situation that you find yourself in. So don't identify with this mistaken identity. It is also a projection of the mind. Mind means relativity. Mind means duality. Mind means a play between the I thought and the that thought. It has got nothing to do with you. The more you take the position in the mind as the mind, that I am a thinking person, gone. And this only happens when you are under the influence of rajas and tamas. And when do rajas and tamas? What is tamas? Self-forgetfulness. What is rajas? The self-forgetfulness then gets projected. I have forgotten myself. After I have forgotten, what is projected? Mind. What is this mind? Play between I thought and that thought. And then I forget that also, that I am the, that this is going on. Then I get identified with the I thought. By getting identified with the mind, now I am taking the position, I am this I, and I cannot live without that. I cannot live without that called the body. I cannot live without that the wife or children or parents or all the whatever. And this is the fall. This is the projection of that I have got caught up with. So expose yourself. When you are in the mind, even though you may say, I am the witness, if you are thinking, I am the witness, you are still in the mind. Because you are thinking. Because witnessing must happen. By thinking, it does not happen. So then what do? Then you keep shifting the mind from being tamasic and rajasic towards the sattvic. How do you do that? Vivek, vairagya. So you're changing the whole the disposition of the mind itself. When it is in tamas, it is lazy, it is indolent, it is nidra alasya pramad, inadvertence. procrastination, laziness, that is how it expresses. When it is in Rajas, it's addicted to activity. He's addicted to activity. But those activities are not God-prompted activities. They are desire-prompted activities. Great masters are also probably working harder than millions of us put together. So are they under the clutches of the Rajas? No. First they emptied themselves, and then the Lord has chosen that instrument to express and do whatever. But here we are not here to do whatever. Here we are to get out of all doing. I brought that example because we may have a doubt that masters are also doing, they are also doing activity. But it is God-prompted activity. Where is it happening? Also in the dream. It is also happening in the dream. For you. For them, is there any activity? No. Is there any birth and death? No. Is there any identification and attachment? No. Is there any seeker or something sought? No. They never come down from the mantle, from the source that they have recognized themselves to be. So in this manner, here Shankaracharya says, this mistaken identity, taking ourselves to be less than who we essentially are, is the reason for our birth, death, become a seeker, miseries, joys, etc., etc. Therefore, the wise established in the reality call mind as the ignorance because of which the whole world is moving like the clouds are shifted by the winds. This thought we will see in our next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om. Just sit quietly for 2 minutes.